Good morning, students. Today we will do revision of unit 2. In phonics, we will learn silent letter words and words with advanced sound pattern. In whole words, we will learn what are homophones and homonyms. In reading comprehension, I will explain you what are pros and cons. So, let's get started. So let's start with silent letters. Now what are silent letters? Some words have silent letters that are not pronounced. It means while saying the word, the silent letter does not make any sound. So here are some examples also. Like here, letter B is silent. As we speak this word, lamb, lamb. So letter B is silent. Here letter N is silent, like in autumn, autumn. Letter L is silent. As we say this word, half, half. L is silent. Okay, letter H is silent. As we are reading this word so many times, so it is honestly. We never say honestly. H is silent, so we say honestly. Letter W is silent. As you can read any of the word, so it is sword, sword. W is silent. Letter L is silent. Read all the words. You have to read all the words. I'm giving you a few examples. So castle, castle. Few other words with silent letters are handkerchief. We never say handkerchief. D is silent here. So we say handkerchief. Wednesday. Okay, students, do practice of all the words. Now let's learn how to read words with advanced sound pattern. For that, I'll show you one CRL. Please see it carefully.
Let us read some words with advanced sound patterns. When the letters C and H come together in a word, they make the K sound. Let us read some words with the K sound. K as in school. K as in school. K as in anchor. K as in anchor. K as in stomach. K as in stomach. K as in cord. K as in cord. Similarly, when the letters E and H come together in a word, they make the th sound. Let's see some words with the th sound. Th as in phone. Th as in graph. Th as in phonics. Th as in trophy.
Students, I hope you all have seen CRL very carefully. Now let's read some words. As you have learned, when letters CH come together in a word, they make K sound. You can read some words like in school. Read this word, orchestra, anchor, stomach, chorus, scholar. Students, do practice of all the words in which CH letter comes together. When letter PH come together in a word, they make sound. Okay, so read some words like alphabet, alphabet. physical, physical, phonics, phonics. Let's learn some more words with advanced sound pattern. So let's see one more CRL.
Let us read some words with advanced sound patterns. When the letters T, I, O and N come together in a word, they make the shun sound. Let us see some words with the shun sound. Shun as in fraction. Shun as in addition. Shun as in station. Shun as in direction. When the letters S, I, O and N come together in a word, they also make the shun sound. So let us see some more words with the shun sound. Shun as in mansion. Shun as in television. Shun as in division. Shun as in confusion.
I hope you enjoyed the CRL. So let's read some words. Like you can read vacation, education, location, and last one word is lotion. Some more words where at the end S-I-O-N is there, but the sound is of shun only. So tension, admission, permission, and last is extension. Children, practice all the words. There are some more words with advanced sound pattern. The word CI, when comes together in a word, it makes the sound of sh. Let's learn. Again, we'll see one CRL.
When the letters C and I come together in a word, they make the sh sound. Let's read some words with the sh sound. Sh as in magician. Sh as in musician. Sh as in delicious. Sh as in physician. When the letters T and I come together in a word, they also make the sh sound. Sh as in patient. Sh as in impatient. Sh as in initial. Sh as in partial. When the letters T, U, R and E come together in a word, they make the chur sound. Let's see some words with the chur sound. Chur as in fracture. Chur as in sculpture. Chur as in picture. Chur as in mixture.
Let's read some words. Precious, precious. Crucial, crucial. Special, special. Spacious, spacious. Martial, martial. Next word is essential, essential. Cautious, cautious. Next is patience, patience. Now T-U-R-E words, when they come together in any word, they make sure sound. like signature, signature, furniture, furniture, then departure, departure, moisture, moisture. So students, do practice of all the words. And I hope you will be able to read all the words. With this, we have finished our phonics part. So let's begin whole words. In whole words, we will learn what are homophones. Now, homophones are the words which have same sound but different meaning and spelling. So when we speak homophones, they have same sound, but their meaning and the spelling is different. So let's learn some homophones. To learn more about homophones, let's see CRL. Students, see it very carefully.
Let us learn about homophones. Can you identify the meaning of these words? My family ate together today. Can you identify the meaning of these words? I read 8 articles in school.
As I told you students, they have same sound but different meaning. As you have heard just now, 8 and 8 sound is same, but spelling and the meaning is different.
Here 8 means the number 8 and 8 means to eat, which is the past form of the word. What are homophones? Homo means same and phone means sound. So homophones are words which have the same sound but different meaning or spelling. Let us learn some more homophones. What do these homophones mean? My main aim today is to practice typing. The zebra's mane was shiny and smooth. What do these homophones mean? M-A-I-N, main, means most important. And M-A-N-E, mane, means long hair on the neck of an animal. The bear walked past the tent. I walk with bare feet in my house. B-E-A-R means a type of an animal. And B-A-R-E means something which is uncovered.
Students, you can open your student reader and learn homophones. There, so many homophones are given. You can read the words and their meaning and learn the difference between both the words. Now we have learned what are homophones. So we'll be learning what are homonyms. Homonyms are the words that have the same sound or spelling but different meaning. So they have same spelling but their meaning is different. So let's see one CRL.
Let us learn about homonyms. What is the common word in these sentences? I wear my glasses every day. The glass is filled with water. That's right. The common word is glass. The first meaning of glass is we use this on our eyes to see clearly. The second meaning of glass is We use this to drink water. What are homonyms? Homo means same and nym means name. So homonyms are words which have the same sound, same spelling, but different meaning. Let's learn some more homonyms. What do these homonyms mean? I left the bat at his house. Most bats eat insects. The first meaning of bat is an object which is used to hit a ball in cricket and baseball. The second meaning of bat is a small flying animal. What do these homonyms mean? You can park your bicycle outside my house. The new park has many facilities. The first meaning of park is to bring an object to pause and leave it at a particular place. The second meaning of park is a public garden. What do these homonyms mean? I have a savings account in a bank. We will set our camp on the river bank. The first meaning of bank is an institution where people can borrow and deposit money. The second meaning of bank is a land alongside a river or a lake. What do these homonyms mean? The carpenter used his saw to cut the wood neatly. I saw a meteor last night. The first meaning of saw is a tool for cutting wood or other hard materials. The second meaning of saw is to see, which is the past form of the verb.
So students, you can open your student reader and you can see here are some examples. So many examples are given, so you can learn that what is the difference between. Okay, do practice. Now let's learn what are pros and cons. Pros means good effects and benefits, whereas cons means bad effects and disadvantages of anything before forming your opinion or before deciding what you want to do. So let's check an example. Let's look an example of pros and cons of wearing uniform in school. So pros are, it saves time while getting ready in the morning. It makes everyone equal at school. It gives student a sense of pride. It builds a feeling of community among students. And cons can be, it restricts the freedom to choose what the students want to wear. It costs money to buy uniform. Uniform can sometimes be uncomfortable to wear. So everything have some positive effect also and some negative effect also. So we need to understand what are the good effects and what are the bad effects of anything. Students, this is all for today. Tomorrow we will revise remaining topics of this unit.